In last week's lectures, we covered a lot of generalizations and basic background concepts without going into very much detail. In this week and in the weeks ahead, we're going to get down to the nitty-gritty of particular model classes. And to start with, we'll be dealing with basic linear models for classification and regression. These models are very simple and very common. If you have any kind of quantitative background, you may well have encountered them before. The basic model assumption is that all of the model variables, both the inputs and the outputs, are continuous, and the output is simply a weighted sum of the inputs, possibly with an optional intercept term as well. Linear models are very widely used, and you encounter them basically everywhere. This is partly because they are easy to construct. They're easy to frame and explain and interpret. But also, many relationships really are linear. And even complicated relationships often have a very substantial linear component, to the extent that it may well be possible to ignore or gloss over the other more complicated elements. Many other kinds of relationships can be converted into linear ones by relatively simple pre-processing methods. You've probably seen quite a lot of plots in the last couple of years with logarithmic axes. This is an example of such conversion. Linear models involve relatively weak assumptions. They have a very long history, and they're very well understood. And they're widely available and accessible to users. If you want, you can do them in Excel. So let's consider some specific examples. It's a very long time since I did A-level physics, and it's possible that things may have changed since then, but certainly in those days we spent a lot of time doing things like hanging weights off wires and measuring their extension, and using these experimental results to confirm well-known physical laws. Things like Hooke's law and Ohm's law are very straightforward linear models with a direct linear relationship with no pre-processing required. Linear models also crop up frequently in finance and economics. In this example of The Economist's Big Mac Index, linear models are used behind the scenes to do the adjustment for GDP from one country to another. Linear models are used to express scaling laws encountered in biological systems and also in social environments like cities. Sharp-eyed amongst you will notice that the axes of these plots are logarithmic. This is how you convert something which is essentially a power law relationship into a linear one. Similarly, these examples, coming inevitably from the spread of COVID in the last couple of years, again use logarithmic transformations to adjust for the exponential nature of disease transmission. Linear models are not inevitably the right model for the job, and certainly they are often used in slightly dubious ways. These examples from a very poor paper on facial trustworthiness show fitting of straight trend lines to data where that does not seem to be the most sensible thing to do. One question that you might reasonably ask in this context is, does this count as machine learning at all? Both the problem and the solution long predate the advent of digital computers, having been published by Legendre in 1805 and probably known to Gauss years before that. The problem has a solution in closed form that, given certain assumptions, is optimal, and for small data sets it is feasible to calculate the answers by hand. It is a standard statistical tool that is widely used by everyone. However, it's an important foundation for later and more complicated methods, and it extends naturally to more complex and computationally intensive models. For that reason, it is usually seen as being a kind of foundational part of machine learning.